Hello, here's another problem for us to look at time series and cross-sectional data. So in this particular data set, I've got income per person, or specifically gross domestic product per person, in fixed 2000 US dollars. That's year 2000 US dollars. So the first problem here, what are the variables of interest and what are the elements? We've answered this question a number of times before, so I hope at this point it comes quite quickly. Variables interest, so here we only have one variable of interest, and it is essentially the title of our table. So here's our one variable of interest, and what are the elements that we're looking at. Here we have all of our elements are conveniently located down that first column again, and so here are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This time we have 6 elements in this data set. Part B, are the data cross-sectional or time series? Again, it depends on exactly what we're looking at. I can consider just one year of data. So if I just look at, let's say, 2008, this is cross-sectional, where I'm looking at a slice in time. So I know that GDP per person is changing across time. If I just look at one moment in time and compare that, as we are here across each of our 6 elements, then that is cross-sectional data. If I wanted to see how is average income changing over time, well, then I could identify or I could isolate either just one country. So I could say, let's see what's happening to average income levels in the United States. And so I could plot that over time. That would be time series data. Or if I just looked at a subset or even all of these countries altogether, well, now I'm plotting as time series data, and I'm able to also compare across each of these different elements. So again, cross-sectional data, we're just looking at one slice of time, whether it's just 2011 or just 2010 or any one of those years, one moment in time, and we can compare those values across our elements of interest. Time series data, so here if we're looking at any one row in this data set or multiple rows where I'm looking at how that variable behaves over time or how the variable is changing different values for that variable over time. And we can incorporate multiple elements in that same definition. So I can compare how it's changing over time across each of my different elements. Okay, so that's a nice quick video looking again at time series and cross-sectional data. Okay, I hope that helps. Thanks.